Hello viewers, good afternoon to you all. I hope most of you got a good news today. Today, the 9th of April, happened to be the day admission list for 2021-2022 session was released. And it has been good, as majority of the people were given admission. And this popped up many questions, as majority of you are confused on what to do next. So some people have been asking, after this, what's next? When are we to start applying for residence permit? What about accommodation and all that? The purpose of this video is to clarify this. First of all, I want to let you know that I won't be talking much about the residence permit application in this video. This is because it is, due to the intricacies involved, I would want to dedicate a full video for residence permit application. So in this video, I will talk majorly about how to apply and get accommodation as a student in Sweden. So there are things you need to know about accommodation when it comes to Sweden. There are many places where it is difficult to get accommodation, and some other places where accommodation is relatively easier. For example, if your school is located in big cities like Stockholm, Gothenburg, Malmo, Uppsala, these areas, it is usually difficult to get accommodation. And because of that, you need to, start off on time so as to acquire points. Because in Sweden, they make use of what they call a queue point system. So I will come to that later to explain what is meant by queue point system. Okay, I also want to tell you that you don't need to worry about how to go about this, because your individual schools will, maybe from next week start sending out mails to the admitted students. So in some of their mails, they will likely tell you about how to go about accommodation in the city where your school is located. Okay, so having said this, I will also want to let you know that in Sweden, there is what is called a first-hand agreement and second-hand agreement when it comes to accommodation. First-hand simply means that you are dealing directly with the landlord, whereas second-hand means you are, a kind of getting a subletted apartment. For example, maybe I rented a place and then wish to sublet some sessions or some part of the apartment. So that is second hand. So because you are not dealing directly with the landlord, but maybe a tenant who happened to be the original tenant directly with the landlord. So I would also want to let you know that the type of accommodation you will go for, of course, just like every other country, there are many types of accommodation here in Sweden, and the type of accommodation to go for depends on whether you are coming alone or you are coming with your family. So for example, there are something like Safecon, as we have in Nigeria and most other countries. There is maybe what we call a corridor apartment. So it is like maybe I won't in Nigeria, maybe we can say face me, I face you, but in this particular case, it is not face me, I face you, but maybe somehow a line house, something of that nature. And then we have apartments. So the type of apartments here depends on whether you are living alone, because some apartments are meant for only a single individual and not a family. So for example, if you are living alone, you can maybe secure accommodation in a 3-bedroom flat where you have a room to yourself and you will be living with two other students, you know, occupying the remaining 2 rooms. And then all of you will have to share a common kitchen, a common dining room, a common toilet and baths, and then a common sitting room. So, but for Safcon, you have your own toilet and bathroom, but you also have to share kitchen with other students. You also have to share sitting room with other students, and so on and so forth. But if you are coming as a family, of course, you can share because already you are large, okay? So that means you can go for maybe 2-bedroom apartment or 3-bedroom apartment. And the cost depends on the number of rooms in the apartment and the size of the room as well. So coming to what I said earlier on about the queue point system, just see queue as maybe you went to the bank to withdraw money and you discover that there are many others before you. So what happens? They will have a queue and then you have to join according to the time you came. Okay? So it is the same here. So when you register, you start accumulating queue points. For instance, if you register today, then tomorrow, your queue point will count as 1 day. Then, in 2 days' time, it will count as 2 days. It keeps on increasing by the day. So, what happens is that if there is an advert for a vacant room, okay, then you will apply. Most other people will also apply. Now, how do they allocate this room? So, what they do is, they look at the queue point. The first 10 people in the queue will be, you know, a kind of giving a message that they are qualified for the room. So all other people will fall off the competition and have to try again when another room is advertised. But many a time, they advertise several rooms and you are free to apply to about 3 rooms at once, which means that you have 3 chances. If you don't get this one, you can get another one. So it is usually nice for you to check the rooms where the competitors or the applicants have maybe comparable queue points with you, because sometimes you will tend to compete with people with maybe 1,000 days of queue points, and probably you still have like 30 days or 10 days as your queue point. You see that the gap is too much, which means you can't compete favorably. So you have to, you know, maybe look at, but there are things many people consider, you know, like cost. Cost is also very important. Some people consider cost. And then, because since you are not here, you don't know the location of the room, you don't know, but of course, they used to give a few description about the room, like the size, the floor it is located, whether it is located on the down floor, first floor, or second floor, depending on. So with this, you can make your choice. Okay, so you have nothing to worry about. Just like I said, all you need to do is to wait for your school to send you details on how to go about accommodation. Because of course, for you to apply for residence permit, you have to, you know, show the immigration officers that you already have a place to live or that you will get a place to live. You get. So as a student, you will always tell them that yes, you already have a place in the student hostel, or that you have already applied for a place in the student hostel, something of that nature. So, but accommodation is very, very important. So that is it. I don't know, is there any other thing I need to talk about? Okay, maybe for those that will be coming to Dalarna University. Dalarna University has two campuses, one in Bolenge and another one in Fallon, depending on your course. And in Bolenge, we have the company managing accommodation here is called Tunabigen. Tunabigen, okay? So, and they have their website, tunabigen.se. Then for those that will, studying in the Fallon campus, the company in charge of accommodation there is called Kopparstaden. So Kopparstaden is a Swedish-based company which handles accommodation for maybe students and residents in Fallon. So Michael Oppenhammer, the international marketer for Dalarna University, will soon send out emails to all the students admitted to Dalarna University, giving you all the information you need to apply for an accommodation. And there is something I want to let you know. Sometimes some people would tend to maybe live in Fallon even though they will be studying in Bolenge. It may be nice, but you have to consider cost of transportation, because if not for the fact that we are in a pandemic era, you have to be attending classes. Now imagine living in a place where you have to commute to and fro every day. So you have to, add up the cost of transport for the month, and you see it will end up increasing your expenses. So if you don't have any good reason for doing that, please don't do that. So just apply to the location where your campus is. So if your campus is in Bolenge, apply for accommodation in Bolenge. If your campus is in Fallon, apply for accommodation in Fallon. It happens, this is true for people from other universities like Lund, Gothenburg and so on. So this is very important. At this point, just like I said earlier on, I would wait for your questions, because apart from accommodation and applying for residence permit, I don't think there is any other thing you need to do now. But the truth of the matter is that scholarship holders, you only apply for residence permit when SI would have sent you an official scholarship offer letter, which usually comes in May. Okay, they will release the scholarship list on 28th of April, but the official offer letter will be sent individually via email around the first week of May. So with that official offer letter, that's what you will use to apply for your residence permit. So this simply means that you can definitely apply for a residence permit from May upwards, okay? But you can start now to work on your accommodation, at least to start gathering points, okay? For those that will be coming to Dalarna University, if your campus is in Bolenge, I have said it before now that the company responsible is Tunabigen. You can search for their website on Google and then try to create an account there now to start accumulating Q points. So if you should be going to Fallon, Copperstaden, okay, so you should also apply now to start accumulating Q points. For those that will be going to Lunds and other places, if possible, I advise you to reach out to other students already in those schools if they can help you with the link to the the accommodation company where you can apply. At least you start now to accumulate Q points. So that is all I have for you today. See you again when we talk about how to apply for residence permit. So, but if you have any question you feel I forgot to touch, you can ask your questions while we go through it again. I mean, so that's it. Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe if you have not done so. So, thank you and goodbye.